welcome back to the Beating to Bushcraft Halloween episode. I advertised it on the Facebook page a week ago, 2 weeks ago maybe. I'm not going to release the location where we are. This is a dangerous place. Not many people, I've not heard anyone coming here and making it out alive, so I don't want you coming here and putting yourself at risk like what I'm doing right now. Because this is sheer stupidity what we're doing tonight. I'm here with Ryan, you just seen there. We came across a camp that was already built. We're going to try and fix it up a wee bit and spend the night here. I can only imagine what happened to the people who used that camp or here before. There's no sign of them. It's deserted. They may be alive, they may not. However, I'm just going to crack on when they get the camp set up and bring you guys back. And without naming the location, I'll tell you a wee bit about this area. You wouldn't have got a very clear look at what the shelter looked like earlier, but it was all caved in and whatnot. So what we've done is we've completely dismantled it and put a load of ridge poles up, three ridge poles. We're going to put a roof here and then just a couple of sides, well, the back, and leave this bit here open. Have a fire out the front there. And if we've got time, maybe put a wee fire reflector there actually, and that'll help bounce the heat back in towards the shelter. Ryan and I arrived at location a bit earlier than me. You might see his setup over there. I'll take you over in here, look at that later on, but we've maybe got, I don't know, 45 minutes to an hour of daylight left, so I kind of really need to get cracked on with this, and I need to get my hammock and that set up for the night. We'll crack on. See, just before I do that, actually, I'll just show you. I've got a new watch for my birthday. It was Beating to Bushcraft's birthday the other day there, last week. I don't know, you maybe not see that very well, Ron. Right, there you go. It's a G-Shock one. I've always wanted one of them. I like the tactical green colour. Great for being out here in the woods. So I got that for my birthday for my wife, so I know that she'll be watching this, but I like to thank her anyway. Also got a couple of other bits and bobs, a kit that I wanted to try out today. Got a new speaker with my father-in-law, which I've hooked up to my phone, and you get really great sound off of that, and it sounds great here in the woods. And I also got a power bank, which isn't anything special to look at. But I needed it for charging my phone and camera and speaker. So I'm just going to get cracked on now.
That's a shelter fixed. As you can see, start now. But I have let's see, hold on, see if I can illuminate that a bit better. Get it off the green torch. Right, there we go, let's see if we can make that slightly better. So there we go. You can see, in fact it's not that dark, it's actually because it was just maybe it was shining into the... So you see, it's got a roof on it, two sides. And where Ryan's stood now, we're probably going to put the fire just in front of the shelter. Maybe a wee fire reflector. And that'll do us for the night. This is actually a new torch that I'm using. So it's got white, a red setting where you can see, you can open the out wide like that or change it into almost like a beam. I'll actually probably do a better demonstration of it later on the night. Blue setting as well, green, white, red. I think the red setting will be really cool at night actually. I forgot to mention, the whole reason we came here, obviously it was a Halloween video, but it's actually the eve of Halloween, so as of from midnight to night, that's us in Halloween. So, who knows, we may see a ghost, we may not, we might not even make it out here alive. But just, well, do you know what, I'll actually give you a better look at it. So there you go, it's the Dask fire torch. Just reveal their own. That just pops in and out, and that's what creates a beam. into a spot and whatnot. It's just got the one mode button at the back there that turns it on and off and changes the colours. 4-in-1, and it takes 3 AAA batteries. But I'll have a look at the colour in my hand, black for building that shelter. But yep, this fire torch, I'll have a better shot at the night. Well, that's as a set up for the night now. Got a fire going, everything's soaking wet, so we did bring another bag of dry wood, there's just to help keep the fire going, because everything's soaking in. We'll struggle the night if we didn't bring this dry bag. But that's us all set up in the wee shelter now. I get a white light. There we are, white light. Then my chair there, my wee table set up with a speaker on it, power bank cables, a few beers, my dinner and all that for the night's in the bags there. Ryan perched hey, there.
Go and grab a beer. Since you've got yours out, mate.
Time for a beer.
Alright.
And sit by that fire. Creepy. We've heard some strange noises tonight. Stranges. The strangest of noises. Noises that will haunt your soul. I'm just joking. Mind just farted. That's like a disco deck. Right.
Let me put some tunes on.
Right, so, anyway, let's say, there we go. Right. So, it's not that late, however,
it's pitch
dark, we're going to get some dinner on the go, we're going to cook up some burgers and a few different things. Fire's going strong, not, it's everything's soaking wet down here, so we're struggling with the fire. Did bring a bag of firewood, dry stuff, kindling dry stuff at a supermarket, which I hate doing, but the Scottish weather, that's you've kind of got to do that if you want to hear a good fire at night. So yep, gonna get dinner going. It is currently 7:45 at night. We're gonna get dinner cooked, have a couple of beers, get the music on, and as the night gets on, ghost hunting. And do you know what? I'll bring you back later on, because I was actually going to tell you about the ghost of the area, and I may reveal our location. So first meal of tonight, sorry I'm actually raising my voice a wee bit, is a stir fry cooked by Ryan. Go on Ryan, run me through the ingredients, because that is phenomenal.
So it's basically just obviously chicken's the meat that's in it. It's mostly teriyaki
sauce.
And then there's like, what I've done was, I got a wee bag of the stir fry mix you get from Lidl.
No, you didn't. You prepared all the ingredients fresh by hand. I watched you doing it. He's lying. He didn't buy anything pre-packed.
I shredded it all from hand.
Yep,
you shredded it all. The carrots, the onion, you know, the ginger and all that shit. All shredded by hand, of course. And
nothing came out of packet, did it?
Nothing came out of packet, mate. No.
Absolutely
what
not.
What makes you think that, Ben?
I don't know.
Never think that.
But look at how great does that look? That there is good cooking and good eating out in the woods. I'll bring you back at the next meal, because every time I turn my camera on, it cuts the music to the speaker. So I'll bring you back. Next meal's cooked by myself, and it's not going to be as exciting as that. It's going to be a couple of cheeseburgers, but I'll tell you what, they're going to be phenomenal cheeseburgers.
Number two.
I'll bring you back, yeah. Dos. Cheeseburger, seeded brioche bun, steak burger, melted mozzarella, some onion, and a burger sauce.
Hey,
unos, dos, tres, cuatro. Aye, so it's a burger.
A burger is basically aye. Burger done in an accent.
Burger in an accent, right, yeah. The first bite, how is it, Ryan?
Good, mate.
Just good. Bit on sound effects, go, that's nice.
That's nice.
There you go, that's better. So we're going to tuck into that. There you go, that's better. That's a better view. So look at that. Absolutely beautiful. Me eat that.
Oh,
more tunes. Your beer.
I think it was then, but it might have been. Might have been the what was it? The spirit of what? Center Bridge.
Ryan has just went and revealed our location.
The spirit of an unknown location.
Ryan just mentioned it. We are in an area of the Galloway Forest, the Stinter Bridge. As soon as he's given me the location, it's maybe now to tell you. Maybe now is the time to tell you about. So Ryan gave away our location there. We're in the Galloway Forest, in the Dumfries and Galloway. Particular part called Stinter Bridge. We're not right at Stinter Bridge. We're about a kilometre away from it. Deep in the forest, where not many people venture due to the strange noises, the disappearance of people. People who have ventured in here very rarely make it out. There's an old folktale from round here. A spirit that haunts these woods. The satanic Stinter spirit. At the end of the video, what I will do is I'll flash up a picture of what people have described that they have seen in these areas of the forest. If you're watching this video now, we made it out. We are maybe one of the few that have survived the night in this area. But then again, if you're watching this, we might not have made it. It might have been our camera found by other people exploring this area in the forest. Brave people, people like us, bring you guys back later, because we are now on Spirit Watch. Rustling around. Well, that's it gone. 20 past 11 at night. No sign of ghosts. Did you catch any ghosts in the video so far? I've not seen any. So, it's another 40 minutes till midnight, another 40 minutes till Halloween actually starts. So, who knows, maybe in the next 40 minutes, there may be some spiritual activity around about us. But, the way I'm feeling right now, I ain't going to see midnight. I'm in my hammock, Ryan's just getting into his hammock now. I've got a coffee, which is down here. In fact, you would have seen me pouring that in the video. So, yep. You see that? I don't know if you see that. Steaming hot cup of coffee. And as I always traditionally do, whilst out camping, I have also got, where is it, somewhere in here. It's usually I buy a Haribo, but I went for something different this time. I've gone for a...
You want some Haribo?
Oh no, I've got some Rowan Trees Random Juicers. So, I'm going to have a couple of them, my coffee, and watch something on my phone. So if anything spooky or spectacular happens during the night, I'll turn the camera on, but chances are I'm going to be sleeping, so see you guys in the morning. Peace out. Good morning. That's not a good morning. Absolutely chucking it down. And by the way, I had the tarp set up last night, and it's not just the rain, it's windy as well, so the wind is whipping right through the camp here, blowing the rain in sideways, so the stuff got wet, I'm wet. The idea this morning was to get up. Wasn't going to have a fire this morning, we're just going to use a gas canister and cook up a breakfast. Ryan's still sleeping, the clocks went back last night as well, so it's currently 8:30 in the morning. You can see it's still pitch dark out here. So yeah, I'm going to keep packing my kit away, letting Ryan getting up, we'll maybe cook up breakfast and then head out here. Well, that's why I can go up now, and there's no danger of getting a fire going in this weather. It's absolutely chucking it down. So Ryan's got a jet boil with him, and a wee cup of coffee. And we're just going to cook some breakfast now. So we're underneath that wee shelter that we built last night, just trying to keep in out the rain. I've got my kit packed up and ready to go. Ryan's no packed his up yet, because he's a lazy bugger, I'm going to get out of his bed. We're just going to have a bit of breakfast, some coffee, some square sausage there, and some bagels, and toast them up a wee bit in the pan. Jeez, just listen to that rain. The camera doesn't show it, but you can... And the ground's just saturated. It's like a swamp around here now. But a nice wee bagel, toasted bagel in the morning cheers you up.
Are these toasted?
Ryan went and made himself a filtered coffee.
No bad.
I just had my wee usual Nescafe sashes. Pencil coffee. Better than any McDonald's breakfast. Steak slice, square sausage, nice bit of cheddar cheese and a toasted, what do you call them? Bagel?
Yeah, toasted bagel, aye. That's in it? Aye, it does.
Smells phenomenal too. So that's all the kit packed up. Pretty much just going to grab that and head out of here. Had our breakfast, had our coffee. But I just noticed the one they see there. See all that froth, all that foam coming out the tree? I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure that happens when the trees took on so much water due to the amount of rain that we've had. The water has to then be discharged, shall we say. It gets discharged out the tree, and that's what happens. That's the tree now rejecting water as it's took on so much with the amount of rainfall that we've had over the last few days.
Well, that's be all packed up and out the forest now. So we're heading back up to the car, which is just at the back of where the camera is at the moment. Just before I headed home, I'd come down and have a look at the river. See the amount of water that's flowing down it. The amount of rainfall that we've had this morning, there's some amount of water that'll be coming down off the hills. You come here in the summer, that's like a wee trickling stream. You can see there, it's a raging river, isn't it? But yeah, this video, it wasn't anything serious. It wasn't a bush trap video or any wild camping and that. It was a bit of fun. Just a wee fun video that I done for Halloween. So, if you enjoyed it, give it a wee thumbs up, leave me a comment, subscribe to the channel, and again, thanks for watching, and join me in the next one.